Good morning, everybody. I'm Dr. Nitin Joshi, professor in urology with teaching experience of 25 years, working as consultant urosurgeon in Panvel. Today we'll discuss PSA derivatives and their significance in clinical practice. It is important from theory as well as practical point of view. With advent of serum PSA as tumor marker, it has been widely used for detection of cancer prostate. However, use of serum PSA as tumor marker resulted into overdiagnosis and overtreatment. That is, with increasing use of serum PSA, there was increased incidence of unnecessary prostate biopsies. Due to increased incidence of prostate biopsies, there was early diagnosis of cancer prostate. This resulted into increased incidence of local aggressive treatment in form of radical prostatectomy, even in young men. The histopathology evaluation of the specimen from radical prostatectomy, however, shown that many of these patients had a cancer prostate, but it was slow-growing, indolent, clinically insignificant prostate cancer. Thus, use of only raised serum PSA has resulted into overdiagnosis and overtreatment. This is because serum PSA is organ-specific and not disease-specific. That is, raised serum PSA does not mean cancer prostate. Serum PSA is raised because of cancer prostate as well as various benign pathologies of prostate like BPH, prostatitis, prostatic infarction, prostatic stone, prostatic abscess, prostatic manipulation like digital rectal examination, prostate massage, biopsy, TURP, instrumentation like cystoscopy, catheterization, and incidences like acute retention of urine or ejaculation. Thus, there is significant overlap in serum PSA due to cancer prostate or various benign pathologies or prostate manipulation. And this becomes necessary to have some additional tool so as to help the clinician to take a decision with the help of which one can avoid unnecessary prostate biopsies. Here comes the concept of various PSA derivatives. These PSA derivatives which are commonly used in practice are PSA density, PSA velocity, complex PSA, free PSA, percent free PSA, prostate health index. What does these PSA derivatives do? These PSA derivatives actually improve the performance of total serum PSA tumor marker. That is, use of these PSA derivatives along with total serum PSA help the clinician to take the decision which patient should be subjected for prostate biopsies and in which the prostate biopsy can be avoided. It helps to select appropriate patients, that is, patients who have been subjected to the prostate biopsy invariably will have a cancer which is clinically significant and will require treatment so as to prevent cancer-related death. In other words, use of these PSA derivatives help the clinician to avoid unnecessary biopsies, in which case the prostate biopsy will be negative, or if at all positive, it will be slow-growing, indolent, clinically insignificant cancer prostate. What are these PSA derivatives? PSA density, PSA velocity, complex PSA, free PSA, percent free PSA, prostate health index. Now, PSA density, it is calculated as total serum PSA divided by prostate volume on truss. The normal value is up to 0.50 nanogram per ml per cubic centimeter of prostate volume. It gives the information about the aggressiveness of the tumor. This is because it calculates the amount of PSA per gram of the tissue. And so, PSA density helps to differentiate between the benign pathology and the cancer prostate. Also, the degree of elevation of PSA density helps to give information about the aggressiveness of the tumor. PSA density value also helps the clinician as well as patient to select the patient which patient can opt for the active surveillance in case of localized cancer prostate. Other PSA derivative is PSA velocity or PSA dynamics or PSA kinetics. It is the rate of change of PSA. Studies have shown that if the patient who is having the digital rectal examination normal, PSA raise in gray zone area 4 to 10 nanogram per ml. Then, if the rate of change of PSA is more than 0.75 nanogram per ml per year, it is marker of cancer prostate. Also, studies have shown that if the patient before 1 year of diagnosis of localized cancer prostate, if the rate of change of PSA, that is PSA velocity, is more than 2 nanogram per ml per year, it is extremely aggressive cancer. Even if patient having localized cancer prostate, if undergoes radical prostatectomy or radical radiotherapy, that is aggressive local treatment, there is high chance of prostate cancer related mortality. Thus, the PSA velocity also gives information about the aggressiveness of the tumor. More rapid is increase in the serum PSA, more aggressive is the tumor. Next PSA derivative is complex PSA. In case of cancer acini, there is absence of the normal acinar barrier. Normal acinar barrier is formed by the basal cell layer and basement membrane. Since there is absence of this acinar barrier, the mature PSA which is formed in the lumen of the acini is immediately released in the circulation, resulting into raised total serum PSA. But this mature PSA is serine protease, so it easily gets complex with the endogenous antiproteases to form complex or bound PSA. So in cancer prostate, not only total serum PSA but even complex form of serum PSA is increased. In other words, if complex form of PSA is increased, there is always a possibility of cancer prostate. With the help of this complex PSA, one can calculate additional derivative and that is complex PSA density. Complex PSA divided by prostate volume on truss. Now next PSA derivative is free PSA. In case of normal prostatic acini as well as in BPH, there is presence of acinar barrier, which is formed by the basement membrane and the basal cell layer. So normally major proportion of the mature PSA is released in the semen. Very small amount of PSA enters in the circulation. This PSA which is now present in the acini, neither released in circulation nor released in semen, will stay in the lumen of the acini. During its stay, it undergoes further degradation by proteolysis, in which there is internal cleavage of the molecule of PSA forming free fragments. These fragments of the PSA are inactive, that is they do not possess enzyme action. So when released in the circulation, cannot bind with the antiproteases. As a result, these fragments circulate in plasma as free PSA. In case of cancer prostate, on the other hand, the free PSA is major contribution is by the truncated or nick PSA. Truncated or nick PSA are actually abnormal form of precursor PSA. Normally, activation of pro PSA takes place in the lumen of acini with the help of enzyme lumen calcarein 2, where the leader of 7 amino acid is cleaved by this human calcarein 2 to release mature PSA. Abnormal cleavage at abnormal site results into various isoforms of PSA in form of -2 pro PSA, -4 pro PSA, -5 pro PSA. The commonest is -2 pro PSA. So in case of cancer PSA, the free PSA is different than the BPSA or the BPH PSA, where the major contribution of free PSA in cancer prostate is by this truncated or nicked PSA. So we have seen in cancer prostate, total PSA is increased, complex PSA is increased and free portion of the PSA is decreased. On the other hand, in BPH, it is the free PSA which is more increased. With the help of this, one important PSA derivative which is used in clinical practice is percent free PSA. Percent free PSA is calculated by free PSA divided by total PSA multiplied by 100. We have seen that as the free PSA increases, the possibility of detecting cancer decreases and possibility of increased possibility of BPH. On the other hand, as the free PSA decreases, that is percent free PSA decreases, the possibility of detecting cancer in biopsy increases. Till date, there is no cutoff value for percent free PSA. However, the range has been suggested, and that is 15% free PSA to 25% free PSA with average of 18% free PSA. That is, if the patient having percent free PSA of 25% and subjected to prostate biopsy, then possibility of finding cancer in the biopsy is significantly low. That is, such patient can be avoided to for subjecting the prostate biopsy, because more likely that you will find a BPH, and if at all find the cancer, then it will be clinically insignificant. On the other hand, if the patient who is having percent free PSA, which is lower, that is less than 15%, possibility of finding prostate cancer is significantly high, and more likely it will be clinically significant, requiring aggressive treatment so as to prevent cancer related death. Now, significance of percent free PSA. All these derivatives, what we have seen, is important in the patient who is having normal digital rectal examination and PSA raise in the gray zone area of 4 to 10 nanogram per ml. Similarly, this percent free PSA is useful in case of patient who have normal digital rectal examination with raised serum PSA in gray zone area of 4 to 10 nanogram per ml. So, percent free PSA is useful to the clinician to take a decision regarding first prostate biopsy, repeat prostate biopsy. That is, in case the patient is having raised serum PSA, first prostate biopsy is negative, then on serial monitoring of total serum PSA and percent free PSA, if percent free PSA is still low, less than 15%, or is still falling, then the person should undergo repeat prostate biopsy. Studies have shown that the usefulness of percent free PSA is more when the PSA is less than 10 nanogram per ml. If the PSA is more than 10, that is in the range of 10 to 20, then possibility of finding cancer prostate in the prostate biopsy significantly increases to the tune of 80%, and therefore usefulness of this derivative, that is percent free PSA, decreases. But it is also useful for prognostic point of view. As the degree of percent free PSA decreases, it is associated with aggressive cancer, that is Gleason score increases, and is high chance of biochemical failure. So percent free PSA is useful for giving the clinician information about first prostate biopsy, repeat prostate biopsy, aggressiveness of the tumor, and possibility of even biochemical recurrence. Similarly, this significant importance of using minus 2 probe PSA in clinical practice. Studies have shown that as minus 2 probe PSA proportion increases, aggressiveness of the tumor increases. So minus 2 probe PSA is also useful in the clinical practice for the decision of first prostate biopsy, repeat prostate biopsy. Minus 2 probe PSA also increases as the aggressiveness of the tumor increases. Minus 2 probe PSA has been used in the calculation of prostate health index. Prostate health index is FDA approved in case of men with more than 50 years with normal digital rectal examination with PSA range in gray zone area 4 to 10 nanogram per ml to give the information about whether the patient to be subjected for prostate biopsy or not. Prostate health index is calculated by square root of total PSA multiplied by minus 2 probe PSA divided by free PSA. Thus, all these PSA derivatives are useful in clinical practice so as to avoid unnecessary prostate biopsies and increase the yield of prostate biopsies. That is, the patient who have been subjected for the prostate biopsy likely will have cancer prostate and will be clinically significant. Thus, these PSA derivatives use help to avoid unnecessary biopsies and hence discomfort and cost to the patient. Here we finish the topic, that is PSA derivatives and their significance in clinical practice. Thank you very much.